Over one-third of Ireland's farms are owned and worked by people over 65. Age is no drawback to farming, as 70-year-old Michael McMahon can show.
I'm talking to a man, I suppose. The fare wasn't too worried.
Michael is a bachelor and has lived alone with his bachelor brother Patrick since they inherited the family farm. The bachelor problem is another sad fact of Irish rural life.
You know what? Wait, we'll have a show on the fiddle. Would you like it? I've got it. Yeah. Ah, yeah. I'm half drunk. No matter. Here goes, no lads.
In this region of County Clare, half the farmers are unmarried or childless. In many cases, there is no one in the family to inherit the farm and work it. So farms like this lie empty and unused. The low marriage rate springs directly from the low income from farming. Farms can only support one family. This means that a son who wants to work on the farm cannot afford a wife while his parents are living. Moreover, nowadays he would find it difficult to win a bride who would like farming. His chances are even more remote if he has remained single into middle age. Life may seem comfortable enough for elderly bachelors, but they're hardly likely to breathe new life into rural Ireland. Increasingly fewer children will be able to enjoy the adventure of growing up in the countryside. Must the quality of life in rural Ireland be sacrificed to progress?
Our primary consideration in the last decade or so had to be economic growth. It's no good preserving the quality of life in Ireland if all the Irish people are living abroad somewhere. We had to create the jobs here and the industries to keep our people at home. That was the first requirement.
Unfortunately, this means keeping them at home in the cities. This exodus from the land in the West angers many Irishmen. But Ireland's entry to the common market will certainly wipe out the small farmer in the interests of agricultural efficiency. Lip service is paid to localized industrial development, but the writing is on the wall. Land has always been the measure of a man's true worth in Ireland. In Ireland's long and bitter history, men have fought and died for land. Now they quietly let it go for a 44-hour week and 2 weeks paid holiday.